Hi, post-initial voiceover recording Altar here. I initially wanted to make a dramatic intro that showed everyone's request on this topic, but as it turns out, there wasn't as many people as I had thought, so it couldn't really work. Plus, I just didn't have the energy to, especially with how editing this was already annoying. But here's everyone that I think requested this. So, yeah, let's move on to the actual video. Back-to-back uploads. I hope YouTube's algorithm likes me now. Please, for the love of God, the past two videos took ages to make. Man, I missed my peak. Oh yeah, special thanks to Girlfield from Discord for helping me out with the equipments I couldn't find. And if you look at RPG Maker and find equipments that I didn't cover here, there are news. If you think otherwise, I will not believe you unless you're the one and only JC Jimmy. Or, you know, maybe someone else who worked on the game that knows this type of stuff. Before I go on, I'm gonna be talking a lot before the thing you came here for, so if you don't want to hear my rambling, go to this timestamp for the equipment guide, or this timestamp for the attributes of the starting gears. Alright, let's proceed. Since I know people are gonna ask about the stats, I'll be adding the attributes somewhere on the screen whenever I'm checking the equipment. Another thing before I continue, I'd like to promote some other channels who have done a similar thing like this, but not with all of the equipments. The first one is Gamer Cafe, who made a tutorial on how to get the rando gears. And the second one is Fantastical, who made one for the Perpetual Ring. Also, the latter showed off other things like how to get Dairy out of Garbage Island. And speaking of Dairy, YOLO Man made a video covering how to get into a new battle with him. Anyway, back to the main topic. I'm not gonna cut part of my content just to promote others, that'd be kinda weird. But I figured I could give them a spotlight, so go watch their videos. After this video, of course, this shit took so long, you better watch it to the end. Anyway, enough of fuckface, that's this guy if you didn't know. Enjoy the guide. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And that's that. Probably the most requested thing to make a video on. So, now what? Well, before I do my outro, allow me to tie up any loose ends. The first one is pairing Scrawny Davy, requested by these users. In order to do this, you must talk to Davy at every location he appears in, which I'll show you now. There's a clear order of progression here. You go talk to him in downtown, then the Bad Angels territory, then you use the shortcut to outside of the feast, then you activate the feast in order for the last DV to appear, then all you have to do is defeat all the mini-bosses in order to get a free petroleum firebomb out of him. Speaking of mini-bosses, it's actually possible to also spare Mikhail. All you have to do is this. I'd like to thank Fantastical and Psychic Paranoia for this guide, since I was already done recording by the time I knew of this. Next, this person suggested a guide for empowered Stefan. While I don't have that, I do have a guide to prevent Stefan from getting empowered in the first place. All you have to do is destroy all his satellites, which I'll show here. Him not being empowered means he won't have access to Heart Squeeze, a move that inflicts the trauma status effect, Heart Attack. Yeah, Stefan does that. If you want to know all the characters that can inflict trauma, look no further than this list that I formatted as a tier list, but it's not one at all. I've already posted this in my community post, but that one is outdated as it doesn't have Shami's Joy Mutant form in it. And so, that's it. I pretty much dug through all the nooks and crannies of this game. Is that the end? Am I just gonna stop making Skull of the Wilbersand videos? Yes, but also no. I won't be making videos on the game itself, but I will continue on stuff related to it, such as my next game, which I haven't continued developing yet, but just know it'll happen. Anyway, even if you make requests, I highly doubt I'll go back to my roots, especially because I really have no reason to get back at this game. I don't mean to sound annoyed, because you gotta remember, this game was really the reason you probably knew of this channel in the first place. So saying goodbye to it just feels bittersweet. I really do feel like this is the end of Scholar of the Wilbersand, especially because JC Jimmy has stopped patching and updating the game. Meaning that if you bought the gold tooth from this guy, then talk to this guy in which he'll ask to get it back, deny that request, then talk to him again and I'll give it to him, Alex will now get a +1 increase to all stats except luck, which gets a +2 boost. Anyway, maybe when the next big Lisa game is out, I can go back to what I was. In the meantime, I'm gonna have to start working on another game, since that's on my list of videos. See you then. Goodbye.